Today we are going to start with the second unit of machine learning, that is feature selection. So first point is how we can train the data set into the training and testing data set. So the question based on that is, what are the criteria or methodology for creation of training and testing data set in machine learning? Or we can say the methods that is to be used for creation of training and testing data set in machine learning. So creating a training and test sets when the data set is large enough, it's a good practice to split it into training and test sets. The former to be used for training the model and later to test its performance. The following figure, we can see the schematic representation of this process using the following figure. So like this, the original data set is there. By using the random shuffling, we are dividing it into the training set and the testing set. So training, first we are dividing the original data set into the two different sets, that is training set and testing set. Now how it is to be divided and what is the methodology to be used for dividing this, that we are going to see. Okay, so here we can see on the upside the original data set is there. Using the random shuffling, we are dividing into the training and testing data set. So there are two main rules in performing such an operation. First is that both data set must reflect the original distribution. That is, train set and test set must reflect the original distribution of the original data set. Second one is the original data set must be randomly shuffled before the split phase. जो भी original data set है वो randomly shuffle होना चाहिए before starting this split phase in order to avoid the correlation between consequent elements. Okay, so with Scikit-learn, what is Scikit-learn? Scikit-learn is one of the library like we are using conio.h, stdio.h. These are the header files which we can say the libraries also, where some definitions are get stored. So like in machine learning, by using the Python, Scikit-learn is one of the library which provides how the data set to be split into training and testing data set. That type of function can be provided by this library. Clear? So with Scikit-learn, this can be achieved using the train test split function. So this train test split function is present in this library, Scikit-learn. Okay. So from the sklearn model selection import, so from this function, we are importing this particular function. Okay. So for importing this function, we need the x and y parameter of the data set. Means data set must may be containing the matrix. Data set may be in the form of matrix or may be in the form of row column type data set. So we have to extract that x and y coordinate of that. So that x and y coordinate we are extracting for both training and testing data set. Okay. So this can be done like this, x train y, x test y train y test. So is equals to train test split x and y. We are passing these two parameters. So for this function we are passing four parameters, that is x, y coordinate and what should be the test size. So test sites means from the data set, how much portion of the data we have to consider into the test set data set that we have to consider. So using the test sites, we can set the values to this parameter using the float values between 0.0 to 1.0. So here default is 0.25. So random state is equals to 1000. So using the parameter random state, what we are doing, we are controlling the shuffling of the data set before splitting. So here the parameter test site allows specifying the parameter percentage of the elements to put into the test trend data set, as we saw. So here we are splitting it like 75 and 25. So 75 is the training data set and 25 is the testing data set. So likewise, we are shuffling the elements of the original data set into train and test data set. Another important parameter is random state, which can accept a NumPy numeric library, random state generator, or an integer seed. In many cases, it's important to provide reducibility for the experiments, so it's also necessary to avoid using the different seeds. Okay, so we can see the different split over here. From sklearn.utils, import check random state. So we are importing that check random state from the utils library of the sklearn. Okay, so the size we are considering as 1000. So here that is to be extended over here. So in RS value we are passing to this parameter as a parameter. Okay, so in this way, if the seed is kept equal, or experiments have to lead to same results and can be easily reproduced in different environments by other scientists. So this is all about the methodologies for creating and creation of testing and training data set from the original data set. Now we will see the second point, that is different mechanisms for managing the missing features in data set. The question can be asked on this point is, explain different mechanisms for managing missing features in data set. So in data set also sometimes certain features are get missing, so we have to find out that missing feature. So there should be some mechanism for finding that missing features, and that mechanism we are looking over here. So sometimes a data set can contain the missing features, so there are few options that can take into account to remove that missing features. So first is that removing the whole line, creating sub model to predict those feature. So we can जो भी हम लोग सब मॉडल means distribution कर रहे हैं उसे पूरी line delete कर सकते हैं for those features using the automatic strategy to input them according to their own known values. The first option is the most drastic one and should be considered only when the data set is quite large. The number of missing features is high and any prediction could be risky. The second option is much more difficult because it's necessary to determine a supervised strategy to train the model for such features and finally to predict their values. First option is that we can remove the whole line for creating the submodel to predict those features. And the second is the using the automatic strategy to input them according to their own known values. So that own known values can be determined using the supervised strategy to train the model for each feature. Means hame kya karna hoga, har ek feature ke liye supervised strategy use karke train karna padega model and predict karni hogi uski value. So it's very difficult. So considering all the pros and cons, the third option is likely to be best choice. So third option kya hai, using the class inputter, which we are implementing using the Python. तो स्किकिटलर्न ऑफर्स द क्लास इनपुटर विच इज़ रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर फिलिंग द होल्स यूजिंग द स्ट्रैटेजी बेस्ड ऑन द मीन. वॉट एवर द मिसिंग फीचर्स आर देयर विच वी कॉल्ड इट एज अ होल्स मीन्स ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर गैप वी कैन कंसिडर एज द होल विच इज़ नथिंग बट द मिसिंग फीचर. सो दैट कैन बी फिल्ड यूजिंग द बेस्ड ऑन द स्ट्रैटेजी ऑफ मीन मीडियन एंड फ्रिक्वेंसी. The following snippet shows an example using three approaches. The default value for missing feature entry is the n means missing value ke entry hum log yahan pe kya kar rahe hai default that is nan. Different placeholder bhi we can use for the missing values. So these are the different mechanisms that is to be tried over here. So data is equals to np dot array like this way we can say. Okay, a generic, so this is all about how a different mechanism for managing the missing feature in data set. So what are that three features? First ki hum log wo whole line jo bhi missing values दे रही है उसको डिलीट कर सकते हैं. दूसरे से हम लोग क्या कर सकते हैं कि पहले हम लोग उसे सुपरवाइज ट्रेनिंग से ट्रेन करके मॉडल उसको प्रेडिक्ट कर सकते हैं वैल्यू को. और थर्ड यूजिंग इन इनपुटर क्लास जो भी है उससे हम लोग उसे फिल कर सकते हैं यूजिंग द स्ट्रेटेजी मीन मीडियन एंड फ्रिक्वेंसी. सो दिस इज़ ऑल फॉर द टूडे. स्टॉप ओवर हियर.